Everyone, allow me a couple of minutes to set up my laptop. By the way, I am the one who is standing between you and lunch, but I believe lunch is not yet ready, so you have to bear with me by that time. Okay, the topic for today is mobile-first designs. Sorry, Radhika, I'm entering into your arena. I'm a developer, but yeah. The whole idea of this particular talk is to give the developer's perspective into mobile first. You can consider it some kind of developer rant against mobile first or mobile first, anything. But these are more or less my experiences with this particular. Mayor, password. Okay, crafting mobile first, a developer's point of view. So agenda today is pretty much simple. Why mobile first? Who am I to talk about it? Adaptive versus mobile first, decisions we are going to take. How WordPress comes into this, and question answers. Yes, over to lunch after the session. First of all, who is my target audience? Mobile first is not something I should be discussing at a developer conference or, okay, let me try. Web designers who are basically looking forward to visualize and create custom WordPress themes, or developers who are building that particular visualization. So everyone who is involved in custom design and development will be my target audience. By any chance, do you know this particular person? It's from a Disney Pixar movie called Ratatouille. He is a chef, Auguste Gusteau, and he has a very famous statement to say, anyone can cook. So similarly, it's me. I have a statement to say, it's not yet famous, but yeah, anyone can code in WordPress. Nowadays, it is that simple. So, when I started knowing about responsive design, I remember that was a time 2012 or even before that, 2010, 11, and people were suggesting that, okay, going responsive is the way ahead and you should look forward for it. And this is going to be the next best thing. And here we are in 2019, almost ending, and responsive is a norm. If you're not building responsive, then yeah. Something is seriously wrong with that one. So responsive web design is now a method, while mobile first is one of the approach. Like Radhika covered in her speech, why? That why comes in here as well. So before we going into the why, let's have some history of it. Mobile first is suggested and advocated by Luke Wroblewski. He is now product head at Google. And in his original book, he mentioned 3 points. Now, these points are relevant in the duration of the when he published his book. That was 2011, I believe. So mobile is exploding. So it is always better to have an experience available for your vast user base. Another interesting point here is mobile forces you to focus. And indeed, it expands your capabilities. So first things first, why? Why mobile first? Like that desktop is saying, why not me? In India, if you look at the mobile users, I'm not talking about smartphone users, it's more than 800 million so far, let us counting from IDC. When we separate out a niche from feature phone to smartphones, we have projections of around 700 million mobile devices by 2023. And they're almost selling like 10 million plus devices per quarter. This may be more, but not less at all. And thanks to new entry providers, 4G, 5G, we have ease and affordability in mobile internet. So people are now accessing contents on the go. I remember a time when I was doing my MBA and I have to buy a pretty expensive age plan if I want to access any internet on my phone. And nowadays, data comes for free. So mobile content consumption is on rise. So we have to cover these things. So our challenges include make sites for mobile, which will be faster, attractive, accessible, most important, and with rich interactions. If I want to book a ticket on the go, I don't have time or bandwidth or fast internet to download an app and book through it. I will prefer one specific website which has a pretty clean, neat, minimalistic layout on the ticket booking side instead of another one for which I require to scroll across a couple of screens and find out which deal is better. Interactions. So we have three approaches. I'm not calling something right, I'm not calling something wrong, but yeah, there are three approaches. One, it's adaptive. You go with the desktop layout, you adapt it for tablet, then you adapt it for mobile, and your job is done. Another is mobile first, going for the mobile design as a focus, provide all necessary information on mobile at a very first stage. Then you will increase or you will further adapt that layout for a bigger viewports. This gives you a flexibility to keep a constant design language and additionally add more contents. And third one, which is fairly popular nowadays, is about buying themes. So buying theme is good, bad, it's nothing like that. But yeah, no purchase theme can replace a custom theme built with a proper plan and good designers. So I'm taking adaptive first. Fairly standard method, I believe majority of people who have built a custom theme use this method pretty fairly. You have an idea that, okay, my layout should look like this. You search around for inspiration. If you don't have a designer around, you be your own designer. You search around for inspirations. I like this particular layout. I like this particular styling. Okay, let me code that one. You can use underscore S. You can use practically any starter theme. Those who are adventurous and skilled enough can start from scratch. Start writing your own style.css, functions.php, and enjoy. Then you adopt it for tablet and mobile. For I have some flashy sign-up box. Maybe I will move it down for the mobile because I don't want people to be distracted with that because I have a very limited viewport. I call it a graceful degradation. Let me explain this in a better manner. So on desktop, we have masala dosa with three chutneys, pretty much tasty food. When I put it on tablet, it uses the very same components, by the way. This is only with one chutney, so I have removed unnecessary sections. Then I put it on mobile, and it will be up by. Yeah, no chutney provided there. I will make it work like, okay, mobile pe itna milega, jada chahiye, ab mobile, please open my site on desktop and you will get more. Okay. Is this a good idea? If you have ordered a masala dosa and you will be served with appe, not a good idea always. So here comes the good, the bad, and of course the ugly. Good, it is a fairly standard practice. People know, designers know, developers know. But what happens when you take a commercial project? You have some day when your client concludes negotiations and you sign up an agreement and you go ahead with the brief and you start designing and the very immediate question is when I can see sample layouts. So adaptive is pretty faster. You have to only build a layout for desktop immediately. एंड यू कैन से कि ओके मोबाइल का हम एडजस्ट कर लेंगे, वी विल एडजस्ट इट फॉर मोबाइल, कूल, फास्टर डिलीवरीज, ईजियर टू बिल्ड. People use something like, okay, Astra team is here, WP Astra and Elementor, deadly combo. Go ahead, build quickly, deploy, get approvals, go live. Amazing. The bad. Like I said, when there is specific functionality expected on mobile, like one of my project, I'm going to discuss it in later part of this. Okay, I still have 15 minutes, so not a problem. They wanted a specific slider to appear on top full screen on desktop, but on mobile the slider should appear below, then slide up, then get activated, and then move on. Now these kind of interactions make it not difficult, but yeah, tricky to build it on mobile. And the ugly, like I said, you have ordered masala dosa, you will be served with idli or appe. Ugly, graceful degradation. Here comes superhero landing. Design for mobile screens first. When I first heard this idea from one of my friends, okay, Abhishek is already here. he was the one who introduced it long back to me, that okay, there is some philosophy like this and this is the way these things work. I was like, which designer will take this ulta approach? कि मोबाइल पे मुझे कैसे दिखेगा एंड देन एक्सटेंड इट फर्दर. बट इवेंचुअली आई फाउंड आउट दैट ओके देर आर मैनी पीपल, मैनी डिजाइनर्स हु एक्चुअली टेक पेन टू बिल्ड समथिंग लाइक दिस बिकॉज क्लाइंट वॉन्टेड, बिकॉज दैट इज द पर्पज, एंड बिकॉज दैट इज द प्रॉब्लम दिस पर्टिकुलर वेबसाइट इज गोइंग टू सॉल्व. अ स्मॉल केस स्टडी हियर, देर इज वन इंस्टाग्राम ब्रांड आई हैव रिसेंटली वर्किंग विद. दिस गाइज गॉट लाइक 100,000 plus followers on Insta. They sell Instagram content, they sell goodies, they sell courses, they sell workshops. Eventually they are a cartoon illustration kind of page. Their main customer is landing up on their website through their Instagram stories or through their Instagram profile. That is the way they earn their leads. In that case, it is very, very crucial that how the mobile layout should be, how quickly it can bring in the conversion for that particular client. And yes, then I realized that, okay, this philosophy works in such cases. But again, on the interesting note, the designer who was working on that particular project was a hardcore adaptive guy. So he was like, I have given you the layouts, build it first. Then we'll look at how it will work on mobile. And there I thought thinking about, then I start thinking about this particular speech, this particular topic. Exactly, that was the time when WordCamp Mumbai was calling for speakers. So I filled in. Prioritizing content is much more important when it comes to mobile first, because you have a very limited space, you have a very limited viewport, and you have a device on which user is very, very focused. It hardly takes half a second to tap on close tab and move on to another app or device. Second place when you can use this particular thing, when you are competitor is a mobile app. Like I said, I have, say, Make My Trip app installed, but I don't want to get into typing those many things. I just want to check if I can get some other fair, cheaper deal for my airfares. I will simply open cleartrip.com. In mobile, works perfectly as fast as app without installing it. Prioritization. Arrange, add optional elements for bigger viewport. This is actually a perk because you are delivering whatever all you are supposed to deliver on smallest viewport in the limited screen size already. So whatever additional you can give it to your customer is perk. is additional. It's fun. And the most part of it is that your design evolves over the screen instead of gracefully degrading over the screen. So end experience is, yes, subject to skills, requirements, briefs. But end experience is usually better. Now let's go back to the food analogy we discussed earlier. Yeah, I look at mobile first like this. That on mobile, you have one vada pav with some onion and half of a chili, bare necessary things to eat. When you get on a tablet, yes, there are a few more things. And on desktop, you get one additional vada pav if you want. Exactly. I believe this one collects better, especially when it is lunchtime. So the good, we have already discussed this particular one. The good, your design evolves. You provide all necessary information, quicker to track, better to convert. Now the next question arises, how to decide if I'm getting a new project and which approach I should follow? First, rule of thumb, discuss your designer. They know better because they are going to visualize. But yes, there are a few more things. Adaptive or mobile? I discuss this with experts. There is a company, a specific company who is into design domain called Left Right Mind. I recently did a couple of projects with them, and I had a real good discussion with lead designer Tarun. He says he takes this call based on following factors, nature of a project. Like I said, if you are building for Instagram brand, more traffic, more visitors are coming from mobile, so it has to be of that kind. The client. This is where the typical Indian situation kicks in. Not everything which works in US, UK, Europe, Australia works in India. Like their credit card get billed automatically. We have to have payment gateways. Simple. So his observation was, if your company leadership is above 60 years or they are dealing into the traditional businesses, they are very less open for even thinking about mobile designs. Sad but true, for them mobile is an entertainment device and it is not considered as a serious business action. Yes, this is a fact. I have seen this. I have been in that meeting where the client strongly insisted that don't show me mobile, show me what it runs on desktop. So at that time it will be a call of a designer whether or not to use this, or whether to use this and not to share it with the client, only give the approval, only take the approvals based on desktop screens. Content. Most of the time it so happens that okay, you get initial brief. Itne par se shuru karo, aur jaise mujhe idea aata hai, I will keep adding to the brief. And that becomes a never-ending process. You start with something very simple. And you end up having, okay, let's add this as well, let's add that as well. I saw one more website. Yeah, they got a really beautiful function. Can we have it on our website as well? Things go on changing. And timelines. Like I said, mobile first takes some good amount of time to deliver your initial prototypes or design actions. Eventual process is way faster, your code is way better than the one which are adopted. Because in adopting, you are writing patches. You are writing custom media queries, you are removing elements, there are many display none, there are many things which are running around with margins and paddings and all that things. But do we have that luxury of initial timeline? Is a question. This case study I have already covered. So how to decide? Summarize these three words. Motive. What problem your website is going to solve? What you're going to deliver to your client? And what is the ultimate aim? Do you want to sell any products? Do you want to get newsletter subscriptions? Do you want to simply announce some event? Depends. Interactions. What kind of interactions you are expecting on it? And third, preferences. Okay, process, this is a very top level view. It is as top level view as you are watching Earth from International Space Station. Define your content and scope, very much important when you're going mobile first, because you have a very limited place, very limited room to play around. Then get a good designer, give him some freedom at least. Don't tell him that, okay, mera site Amazon ke jaisa hi dikhna chahiye. Not required. Give them some freedom and you won't regret. Framework supports. Okay. Bootstrap, fairly popular in India. I believe abroad, Zurb Foundation, fairly popular. These are CSS frameworks who are built mobile first. So you can practically write small viewport queries. And if you don't want to modify them, you can leave them as it is and they will be adapted to the larger screens, larger viewports. Choose your framework well, which supports whatever the adventures you are planning with your website. Then, okay, there is something called SDLC. I call it WDLC, WordPress Development Lifecycle. It is nothing but my term of using your waterfall model again and again and again. Okay, how many of you remember waterfall model, by the way? Okay, thank you. At least someone is listening to me. Okay. So there are starter themes who have mobile first framework, built on mobile first framework. My favorite one is Joints WP, built on Zurb Foundation. There are many. Then you have to plan your interactions, because most of the time while doing WordPress, yes, we have a lot of scope for customization and we have a very limited things which are ready-made. So plan your interactions. You can plan your CPTs and SEFs and everything accordingly. Now this is one concept. I just got it at very last minute. Can we have a viewport restricted queries in WordPress? So for example, there is a blog which is loading 25 blog posts. If I'm viewing it on my mobile, unfortunately using 3G, 4G is fairly available, but yeah, sometimes 3G. And loading those 25 queries might be a load for my network connection. Can we have that one? Just a suggestion, I'm open for discussion offline on this one. And what about the future? I believe the future or present or the whole idea of mobile first is about justifying your contents well across the devices. So content is going to stay. Future is going to add two more sections into this. One has already added, that is context and conversion. So when I say context, I'm not talking about smart assistants. But yes, if I'm opening a website, I'm traveling somewhere in this area, I'm opening a WordCamp Mumbai site, and if it can pop up, okay, this event, next event is scheduled in 15 minutes. Or yes, more chances of conversion. Can we have something like this? So I'm done with this. Road is open for your lunch. But meanwhile, any questions? Please.